Previously on X-Men.
As soon as the keto cuts over, I'll be back here at Hayes County eating some barbecue. I'm excited that today marks the last day of our leg day. It's been an epic journey. All right, guys. All right. So this is probably what a lot of people have been wanting to know. I've been getting tons of questions on like, okay, the keto cut's over.
Not over yet.
Yeah, not yet. We've got 2.5 days, less than 2.5 days.
But I can't wait till it's over.
People want to know, like, how's Crystal feel? What does Crystal think about the keto cut? Like, where's Crystal been? And so kind of explain everything and kind of give her opinion on, like, what the keto cut's been for her. Because, again, like, you guys have seen everything I've been doing. You've seen all the struggles, everything, the ups and downs that I've shared. But what about Crystal's perspective? And so I want to share that in the last, pretty much second to last episode. So, babe, the keto cut, like, how's it been for you?
Stressful.
There you go. Stressful. Why?
You've been very, very busy. And so I've been very busy with the girls.
Yeah.
Which is why I've been MIA again. I always go MIA.
Yeah,
like
when
I get busy.
Yeah, you'll be on YouTube videos and then all of a sudden, like, yeah, go MIA.
Well, I just try to give the girls as much time as I can. And sometimes I find myself getting caught up in, like, the social media stuff, like on Instagram, always on my phone. So I've been trying to stay off it so I can give them my full attention. But yeah, you've been so busy.
Yeah, so that's...
And moody.
I've talked about that. I've talked about that, obviously, guys, like how it was really affecting me emotionally, that I wasn't able to, like, give my kids attention or the attention they deserve. Like, I would come home after the workouts and, you know, like the other day.
He's tired.
I was in just a horrible mood.
Yes, you're just like picking fights.
Horrible mood. I was so drained. My calories were low. And the kids are just being kids. I'm not gonna say they're being bad. They're 2 years old. Like, Lowe's 2.5.
No one
Camila's
was doing
one.
Anything to
and,
this
and
dude.
So, like, I'm crazy. I was just in a terrible mood. Just exhausted, I guess. Yeah. Like, I'm just exhausted. It's just been these last couple of weeks where I really started to notice it. Like,
yeah,
the moodiness, the mood swings.
Being on edge a little bit.
Not having enough energy to keep up with the girls. Like, anytime the girls ask me to do something, I'm like, ugh.
Which is weird, because you, like, never take naps or, like, anything, and I caught you that one day.
Yeah.
He gives me the hardest time when I take a nap.
I do give, and for all you moms out there, I do. I give Crystal such a hard time for taking naps.
It's, like, our biggest
threat. And... She did catch me taking a nap. I'm just like these last couple of weeks, I'm just so exhausted. Like, I'm like, I just need to rest. So again, like, you know, it's been tough, like you said.
But he's been doing really good. Like, I give him credit for that. Yeah. I'm very proud of him when it comes to that, because he sticks to his guns and he does it. I can be drinking a beer in front of him and he won't.
Which is tough.
He might look at me like...
Nah, I don't... I'm used to it now. Like, that. Like, everyone's always asking me, like... Because I used to always show, like... Because Crystal hadn't always been doing keto. And for the most part, Crystal, like... I mean, she looks great. Like, she doesn't have to do anything. She doesn't have to do keto. Now, would keto, like, help her benefit, like, her energy levels?
Yes.
That's what we talk about with Crystal. Like, when Crystal's like, I'm so tired. I'm like, well, yeah. Because, like, when we kind of do get into arguments, I'm like, it's because the way you eat. You don't drink enough water. You don't do this. You don't do that. You need to take this. You need to take that. And Crystal's just like, shut up. I don't want to take anything. Like, I look great. Like, I don't need to, you know, for the most part, she doesn't have to do anything.
No, I'm like, you're not going to tell me what to do.
Yeah,
and
for weight loss, I look at everything for weight loss wise, right? Like, Crystal doesn't need to lose any more weight. Like, so if she wants to have pizza or whatever, like, she can have it.
And a lot of it is, like, it's easier to just eat with my girls, and which I do need to, we need to start getting them back on track, because it's just a convenience thing with me is when I mess up.
Yeah. And I'm used to it. Like, it doesn't even, like, affect me anymore. Chris, like, the girls had Mr. Gaddy's Pizza, which, if you're from Texas, you knew Mr. Gaddy's. It's really good pizza. And, yeah, it's like, it doesn't even affect me anymore. But the beer sometimes does. Like, when I see Crystal drinking beer, and she's like, oh, the girls have gone down for a nap, or the girls are asleep, and she goes to the refrigerator, opens a beer, I'm like,
that's just, like,
I
my
can't
way
wait.
To unwind.
Like, I can't wait to enjoy
it
a beer with
keto
you.
It is keto-friendly beer.
Yes, Michelob Ultra, yes. I cannot wait to just chill and be able to have a beer with you. Like, us just, like, right now. Okay, so we're able to record this right now because my parents picked up the girls and they're going to stay with them tonight. So me and Crystal get, like, a break. And so we're filming
and
this.
My beer is sitting right
and Crystal's beer is right there, like, literally right there. She's drinking it. And I cannot wait to join her. Like, come Saturday night, I'll be able to join her and just have
but
a beer
I will
with
say
her.
That, like, everything being closed has kind of helped us because I feel like I would want to go and, like, have a beer somewhere if we could have.
Yeah.
And so I think
that's
kind of helped, like, the whole situation with us and the balance and...
Yeah, and again, it hasn't, like, this keto cut, like, guys, remember, we started January 2nd.
No, you've been doing really good. It's just literally, like, the past week and a half, maybe, you've just
and
been,
it's
like,
it's now about to be the end of May, and I've had one real cheat meal. Not a cheat day. I have not had a cheat day. One cheat meal, I had a burger and fries, like, and
then you had the keto cake on Camila's birthday.
Yeah, but it was keto cake. Like, it actually did fit my macros. Okay. So on Camila's birthday, Gaines Bakery made Camila this keto cake. Now, I did. It's literally a keto friendly cake. It's made out of almond flour. The icing was made out of, like.
But for you, that's what I'm saying. That's like a cheat. Like,
yeah, that was my cheat, even though it still fit my keto macros. Now, I did eat a little bit too much of the cake. Ross did put it in the plan that you can have a slice. And I maybe had more than a slice. But, like, I'm talking, yeah, we did have to get rid of leftovers. I'm talking more of, like, a real, like, pizza, burger, fries, like, something like that. And for the most part, like I said, it's been tough. It's been such a long road. Like, it's been such a long 6 months. So much has happened during that time. Like, Crystal and I have had our fights where she's just like over it. Like, you know, she's just like over it. And like she said earlier, like she said, we'll be fighting and I'm still getting up in the morning, still doing what I need to do. And, you know, even though we're still like arguing, whatever,
I think there's just been a lot of tension between us.
For sure.
I feel neglected because he's so busy with his keto cut and the girl, I'm frustrated because I'm like, the girls want your attention and you're busy doing this. And
so that is like a lot of like where our fights definitely do like stem and where our fights definitely come is like, I don't know if the camera got cut off or not, but the keto cut has been above everything these last couple of months, or well, last couple of weeks, months, whatever. It really has. It's been above work. It's been above my family. It's been above me and my wife. It's been above my mom, my dad, my brothers and sisters. It's been above everything. And what I mean by that, it's like Matt is my business partner. We're both the owners of Keto Coach. You know, we'll have a list of things that we need to get done and scheduling meetings. And I'm like, oh, no, that's not going to work because I have to train. Oh, that's not going to work because I got to cook the food. Oh, that's not going to work because I got to film this. It's all, like, everything is set around the keto cut. Like, Crystal's like, hey, I need to go here. Like, if you have a doctor's appointment or something, she'll call, like,
I need a bath.
Something, yeah. She'll say, like, when can I go? Like, what's your schedule look like? And I'm like, well, I got to train here. I got to train. It's like, everything.
Which is not normally like him. It's not like him to put us.
No.
After anything.
No, it's never like that. It's never.
It's
and
like,
even
what the heck?
And even I'm like, I told Matt this the other day. I was like, I can't wait for this keto cut to be over so I can start putting, I can put it on the back end now. Yeah. Like working out, eating and all that stuff. Like everything is so strict. Like you have to eat at this time. You have to count your macros. Am I short on groceries? Well, then I have to go to the grocery store because I cannot be without this. This is what the meal plan says. Well, you know that I train at 4 o'clock. So that means I have to stop what I'm doing at 3, start wrapping it up by 3:30, get on the road by 4, get to Ross's by 4:30, start stretching, start our training session at 5, train for an hour, do cardio after, then I'm back home at 6:30. So that's like a huge gap. Like 3 o'clock, prepping to go work out, to work out, to stop working out, to finally get back home at 6:30, sometimes 7, and Crystal's exhausted by then.
Yeah, like, and then I feel like you have all this time, you get to go work out, and so it does. I get resentful sometimes.
And that's where a lot of our fights start. So, and then I get home, and I'm super exhausted. And around that time, is like the girls are really fussy around dinner time. Like they're tired. They're getting ready. Like they've reached their point. They're hungry. They don't know what they want. I'm just got done working out. Crystal's like, okay, thank God you're home. Like it's your, like you're up. Like, and I'm just like, no, like I'm tired. And so like, she's, you know, when we're just like butting heads, cause she's like, dude, like seriously, like I understand you're doing this keto cut, but.
Logan's parents have stepped in and they've helped a lot.
Yeah, my parents have definitely helped out a lot. So for sure, like shout out to my parents, like for helping us.
We appreciate everything.
Yeah, like I said, we wouldn't be able to be filming this if it wasn't for them, because there's no way our kids would never allow it.
And I know, like he's not always like this.
Yeah,
it's just crazy right now, but he's not always like this.
Two and a half more days. So there you go, guys. That is the honest truth. It's been a very, very bumpy road. Relationship wise with me and Crystal, like that's why you probably haven't seen her lately, because she's just like you know what, she's just busy with the girls, like she has to be a mom, like, you know, and I'm over here, like, doing the keto cut and all this stuff, and I'm trying to find a balance of like, I want to have a successful keto cut, I want to make everybody proud, I want to make myself proud, I want to make my family proud, but then also find that balance where I have to also be here for my family at the same time.
And I'm trying to find a balance on being a mom and having time for myself. And so we're both kind of like in this together, trying to figure out.
Yeah. And so that's why you guys probably haven't seen Crystal that much, because she's just always busy. Like she doesn't ever get time to get dressed, put her makeup on, take a shower. And so she doesn't want to be on the camera. Like, you know, like she's not dressed. She's just like, I don't even have my clothes. I don't want to get.
That's what my hair is. I'm like, can I please take a shower?
Yeah. So she's like, she doesn't want to get on camera. Like, I get it. I totally get it. I mean, I'm a guy, so it's like, whatever. I just don't. Sure, but for girls, I know, I get it. Like, I understand you girls want to take a shower, get dressed, do your hair, do makeup, and all that stuff. And so it's tough, right? Especially first thing in the morning when you're doing the same thing every day with your girls. Like, you're stuck at home all day.
I am blessed that I get to, that he does this for a living and I get to stay home with the girls. So I do appreciate everything that he does. I might nag and complain and act like.
Yeah, no, we're both very blessed. Right. And you guys know that. Like, if it wasn't for you guys supporting my family, supporting this shirt that's about to come out probably tomorrow for you guys only. For everyone else on Instagram and Snapchat and Facebook on Friday. But for you guys, I believe it'll be out tomorrow, which is Thursday, if I can edit this video tonight. And if you're from Texas, you have to buy the shirt. Like, come on. Meet me in Texas.
I know,
come
I need on. One. Save me one.
Come on.
Thanks,
buy one. Come on. All right. So there you go, guys. That's the honest truth. That's what Crystal thinks about the keto cut. She is proud of me.
I'm very proud of you.
But
I'm glad that over we it. Can sit down and have a beer together and hash it out.
Yes, I'm excited to finally have a beer with you and kick it. So there you go, guys. There it is. I know a lot of you want to know her perspective of it. And if you guys have any questions for us in the comments, please let us know. I mean, obviously, just write in the comments and I'll try to get to it. We appreciate the support. Yes. I appreciate your support. I know this video has probably gone on a little bit too long and I didn't get an update for the meal plan for you guys, but I'll do it on the next episode. I'm pretty tired myself. I still got to edit this video, and Crystal and I often don't get this alone time. Like, we quietness. Like, Crystal gets to watch TV. Like, Crystal's like excited that we're watching TV.
Bellas, and I'm like cracking
because
up.
99% of the time it's kid stuff on there. It's like YouTube, Play-Doh, and Peppa Pig, and.
I'm so over
Peppa. And Paw Patrol. So she's just excited that we actually get the TV. So there you go, guys. Thank you for watching. Thank you for the support. 2.5 days. The keto cut is almost over. It is peak week. And I'm excited. I'm excited for it to be all over with. It's been a long journey. It's been fun. You guys stuck with us since day one. Thank you. And I couldn't be more happy with the support that I've gotten from you guys.
Yeah,
like, you
I
guys
think everyone
blew my
wants
mind.
To see you drink a beer, so we'll have to record that.
We're gonna do that for sure. For sure. All right, guys, I love you. We'll see you on the next video. Peace.